Hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. I am Manish Mishra, and in today's session guys we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's start today's session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and you have to press this bell icon, and you can also join this Telegram group for updated information regarding the daily sessions and also more information about the course. So let's begin with the very first question, which says community based inclusive development program on rehabilitation of Divyangjan. Divyangjan means person with disabilities, has been co-designed by Rehabilitation Council of India and University of Dash. So you have to fill this gap ki kaun si university ne milke, kaun si university ne Rehabilitation Council of India ke saath milke ye community based inclusive development program ko launch kiya hai. So let's talk about this program. So Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment, which is headed by Mr. Thawar Chand Gehlot. Thawar Chand Gehlot is the minister and he is also the leader in Rajya Sabha, launched a 6-month community based inclusive development program for persons with disabilities or Divyangjans. Now this program guys has been launched to develop trained manpower for rehabilitation and development of Divyangjan. Manpower develop ki jayegi taki दिव्यांगजन यानी कि पर्सन विद डिसेबिलिटीज का रिहैबिलिटेशन किया जाए और उनका डेवलपमेंट किया जाए. एंड दिस कोर्स हैज बीन को डिजाइन बाय रिहैबिलिटेशन काउंसिल ऑफ इंडिया एंड यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ मेलबोर्न फ्रॉम ऑस्ट्रेलिया. एंड ऑफ कोर्स द ऑब्जेक्टिव गाइज ऑफ दिस प्रोग्राम इज टू प्रोवाइड कॉम्पिटेंसी बेस्ड नॉलेज एंड स्किल्स अमंग द ट्रेंड वर्कर्स. बेसिकली द ट्रेंड वर्कर्स की जो स्किल है उनको एनहांस की जाए करा जाएगा ताकि वो अपनी ड्यूटीज को सक्सेसफुली डिस्चार्ज कर सकें. द skills of the trained workers will be enhanced so that they can discharge their duties successfully, and these workers will be known as Divyang Mitra or the friends of person with disabilities. All right, so is news mein hame itna hi padhna hai. The main thing is ki kis kis ne milke isko organize kiya. So therefore guys the correct answer here will be option B, Melbourne, Australia. University of Melbourne, Australia and Rehabilitation Council of India have organized this program. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. In the wake of rising prices in international market by 60% and also or 70%, 60 se 70% ka increase hua hai, there is an increase of 60% to 70% in the prices of diammonium phosphate fertilizers. So the government of India has decided to enhance the subsidy for diammonium phosphate fertilizer, which in short is DAP, from rupees 500 per bag to dash per bag, which is an increase of dash. So you have to fill these two gaps. Now let's talk about this. So the government of India has decided to increase the subsidy for DAP fertilizers from rupees 500 per bag to rupees 1400 per bag, which is an increase of 140%, jo ki hame clearly visible hai. 500 rupees per bag se bada ke 1200 rupees per bag kar diya jayega, jo ki 140% ka increase hai. Now this is obviously guys to ensure that farmers do not have to face the brunt of this rising prices in the international market, jo ki 60 se 70% increase hua hai प्राइस इंटरनेशनल मार्केट में. उसका जो भार है, उसका जो बर्डन है, वो फार्मर्स को बियर ना करना पड़े. द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट स्पेंड्स अबाउट रुपीज 80,000 करोड़ करेंटली ऑन द सब्सिडीज फॉर केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर्स एवरी ईयर, एंड दिस सब्सिडी विल एड रुपीज 14,775 करोड़ टू द गवर्नमेंट एक्सपेंडिचर मोर. 14,775 करोड़ का खर्चा और हो जाएगा इन एडिशन टू द एग्जिस्टिंग रुपीज 80,000 करोड़ का एक्सपेंडिचर बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑन केमिकल फर्टिलाइजर सब्सिडी. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस न्यूज, एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. यू हैव टू फिल द गैप्स. रुपीज 500 पर बैग टू 1200 पर बैग, विच इज एन इंक्रीज ऑफ 140%, विच मीन्स द करेक्ट आंसर शुड बी ऑप्शन सी. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 गाइज. इनोवेशन चैलेंज फॉर क्रिएटिंग एन इंडियन लैंग्वेज लर्निंग एप has launched by MyGOV platform together with the Department of Higher Education. Question is, what is the funding amount for first prize winner? So let's talk about this challenge. So MyGOV.in together with the Department of Higher Education has launched a challenge to develop an app for Indian language learning. ये जो app है ये Indian language learning के लिए काम करेगा, and this challenge aims to get an app developed that will promote regional language literacy. ये जो ऐप है इससे गवर्नमेंट का टारगेट है, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन का टारगेट है दैट दे विल प्रमोट द रीजनल लैंग्वेज लिटरेसी, एंड दैट विल डेफिनेटली रिजल्ट इन क्रिएटिंग ग्रेटर कल्चरल अंडरस्टैंडिंग विद इन द कंट्री. जो हमारे देश की डाइवर्सिटी है, जो हमारे देश का कल्चरल डाइवर्सिटी है इनफैक्ट, उसको समझने में ये ऐप जो है वो हेल्प करेगा. And the selection process, under the selection process, the top 10 teams will be invited to make presentation, and the top 3 teams will be selected by a jury. And these top 3 teams will get funding of rupees 20 lakh, 10 lakh and 5 lakh respectively. So the first prize winner will get rupees, the first winner will get rupees 20 lakh, second will get 10 lakh and the third one will get rupees 5 lakh. So this was about this news, and here the question is asking about the first prize winner. So therefore the correct answer should be option E, rupees 20 lakh. And now let's move ahead to question number 4. Which international organization has collaborated with Telangana government to pilot launch Medicine from the Sky project? Very very important question. Telangana government ka ye ek project hai, Medicine from the Sky, jisme ye drone ki help se medicine pahunchayenge to the primary health center. So the news is that the Telangana government has selected 16 primary health centers for pilot testing the Medicine from the Sky project. Now what is this project? So this project involves delivery of medicines and vaccine through drones. Drones ki madad se vaccine aur medicines pahunchaye jayenge to the primary health centers. And for using drone, the Ministry of Civil Aviation has given the approval under the Unmanned Aircraft System Rules of 2021. And for this, Telangana government has collaborated with World Economic Forum and HealthNet Global. And this HealthNet Global, guys, is a private limited company which works in the health sector. So this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. Which international organization? So it's World Economic Forum. Option B will be the correct answer. WHO is headed by Tedros Adhanom. World Economic Forum, Klaus Schwab. IMF, it's Kristalina Georgieva. And World Bank, it's David Malpass. So these are the chief or the heads of these organization, and so therefore the correct answer is option B, World Economic Forum. And that's it for the session today, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain Monday ke session mein. Goodbye, take care and God bless.